Welcome to a lesson on the story of x. To describe the story of x, we want to write out the steps that describe the operations being performed on x or with x, as well as the operations performed on the result of each step or with the result of each step. Let's look at some examples. Our first expression is x minus 5, so because we're subtracting 5, the story of x is subtract 5 from x. Our next expression is 5 minus x. Here, notice how we have minus x, which means the story of x is subtract x from 5. It is important to recognize the difference between these two expressions. Here we're subtracting 5 from x. Here we're subtracting x from 5. Next, we have the expression 2x, which means 2 times x, and there's two ways to accurately tell the story of x. Because 2x means 2 times x, we could describe the story of x as 2 multiplied by x. But because multiplication is commutative, meaning the order of multiplication does not affect the product, we could also say x multiplied by 2. Technically, x multiplied by 2 means x times 2, but again, because of the commutative property multiplication, x times 2 is equivalent to 2 times x, which can be written as 2x. And again, we know this is true because, as an example, we know that 2 times 3 equals 3 times 2. The order of multiplication does not affect the product. D, we have x raised to the second power, or x squared, or we can also say the square of x, or the second power of x. Let's write the story of x here as the square of x, as well as the second power of x. Now we'll look at some expressions that have more than one operation. When we do this, we will simplify the steps slightly. So our first expression here is 2x plus 4. Following the order of operations, we know we multiply before we add. So to tell the story of x, the first step is going to be to multiply 2 by x, or multiply x by 2. So to simplify things, let's just say step 1 is just multiply by 2. We'll assume we're performing this operation on x. And again, if we multiply x by 2, that really means x times 2, but that's equivalent to 2 times x, which is 2x. After we perform the operation of step 1, notice how we take the result and add 4. So to simplify step 2, we'll just say step 2 is add 4, assuming we're doing this to the result of step 1. Next, we have 2 and then parentheses x plus 4, which means 2 times the quantity x plus 4. Following the order of operations, we know we simplify inside the parentheses first. So the first step is to add 4 to x. And assuming we're performing the operation 2x, we'll say step 1 is add 4. And then for step 2, after performing the operation of step 1, we would have two ways to express step 2. We could say 2 multiplied by the result, or the result multiplied by 2. Let's simplify that and just say we would multiply by 2. And again, we assume we perform this operation to the result of step 1. Now for C, we have 5, then in parentheses x minus 3 squared minus 2. We read this as 5 times the quantity x minus 3 squared minus 2. Following the order of operations, we simplify inside the parentheses first. So the first step, we subtract 3 from x. So to simplify it, we'll just say subtract 3. Step 2, we would raise the result to the second power, or square the result. Let's describe this as raise to the second power. And again, we're assuming we're doing this to the result of step 1. Step 3 would be to perform this multiplication. So we could say 5 multiplied by the result of step 2, or the result of step 2 multiplied by 5. Let's just say multiply by 5. And finally, our last step is to take the result of step 3 and subtract 2. Now let's look at three examples where we're given the steps and asked to write the expression. For part A, step 1 is to add 3 to x, and step 2 is to divide by 2. So if we want to add 3 to x, we're adding 3 to x. So if we want to add 3 to x, that would be the expression x plus 3. And then we take the result of step 1, and we divide by 2. So we take this entire result, or the quantity x plus 3, and divide by 2. It would also be correct to express this as x plus 3 in parentheses, and then divided by 2. These two expressions are equivalent. B, step 1 is to divide x by 2, and then step 2 is to add 3. So starting with x, we first divide by 2. So in fraction form, that would be x over 2, or x divided by 2. Now for step 2, we take this result and add 3. So it's going to be this fraction plus 3. And again, it would also be correct to write this as x divided by 2 in parentheses. And then we take this result and add 3. Now for our last example, step 1 is subtract x from 7. So here we're subtracting x. So we start with the expression 7 minus x, again because we're subtracting x from 7. Step 2, we take the result and raise to the third power. So we need to raise this entire expression to the third power. We need to put it in parentheses, raise it to the third. Step 3, we take this result and multiply by 3. So technically this would be times 3 on the right, but it's more commonly written with a 3 on the left here, again because the cumulative property of multiplication, the quantity 7 minus x to the third times 3 is equal to 3 times the quantity 7 minus x to the third. Then finally our last step, step 4, we take this result and add 1, so we have plus 1 here. I hope you found this lesson helpful.